Hey, this is Wes with Missouri Wind and Solar. We're out at the bench today, and we're gonna go over creating your battery with prismatic cells. We wanted to take a few minutes before we actually get into walking you through setting up your BMS and putting the cells together, and just talk about what this means and even what Missouri Wind has gone through as we've looked at doing this. So this project is one that we've looked at doing for a while now. These actually are in Crystal in my off-grid house right now. So we have 80 prismatic cells that have created 548 volt batteries, and we've been using them successfully for a while now. But we had to go through quite a process to get those to work in our house. And I want to talk about that with you before we just get into setting these up, because there's some things you need to know about getting these set up in your house. The first thing you need to know is that getting these from China, and that's basically where they come from, can be a real challenge. And so even with our connections and how, you know, we're very much in the industry, we experienced about a 20%, I don't want to say failure rate, because that's not exactly right. They weren't exactly failures, but 20% of our batteries were not performing up to the level that they should be. So they were consistently coming in under the 3.2 volts and that sort of thing. And so at the end of our progress, or at the end of our process, so we had all those batteries. We actually pulled out about 16 of those batteries and had to replace them. And what that left us with is the opportunity, and we're kind of looking at it that way, is that we've got the ability to make a sixth battery out of these rejects. That's basically what they are. But the big thing you need to remember, and we've gone over this on our podcast, is that the battery, and when I say battery here, I'm talking about where we add enough cells together to get to the voltage. So if you're doing a 12, 24, 48 volt system, that's adding enough of these 3.2 cells together to get to that voltage. So when you're creating that battery, what you have to remember is if any of those cells are performing low and they're not performing with the rest of it, that basically crashes that whole battery. And so the BMS looks at those, all those cells, and says, hey, you've got, you know, if you have 16 cells in that battery and 15 of them are all in range, let's just say they're, you know, 3.4, 3.5, whatever, but you've got one that's dropping down and it's just a poor cell and it's dropping down to 2.8 or whatever, that whole battery is basically operating at 2.8. And in this case, your BMS is gonna shut your system down. And so you need to really remember that. So if you're buying prismatic cells, what I'm gonna tell you is that you need to allow for these poor batteries. I mean, I don't think there's any way, like right now, we're working on, and again, there's no secret these come from China. We're looking at importing a bunch of these in so that we can resell them. We're excited about them, they're interesting. But right now, we're hung up in an inspection process with them, because a lot of our batteries that we submitted for inspection are failing. And so we're going round and round trying to get these batteries checked out to a level that we will accept them. And you need to look at it the same way. So if you've gone out and you've looked at buying some of these cells on AliExpress or Alibaba or even Amazon, just realize that you need to check these immediately. You need to check them often. And as soon as you get these in, you need to start looking at them, because there can be problems with these, and you need to be on it early. And realizing that returning lithiums, if you didn't go to a store and pick them up, trying to ship them back, That's not a simple process. The normal person off the street just can't walk into the UPS store and do that because the batteries are very restricted on who can ship them and all that. So you need to be very particular about this process. This is something you just don't need to decide on a Tuesday and then go buy them on a Wednesday. You need to really look at what's going on with that. So that's a big thing that we're going through here with Missouri Wind, is just trying to make sure that even the batteries that we're purchasing are of good quality. And like I said, you need to probably have an overage. So, you know, if you're making a 48 volt system like I did at our house, you need 16 of those. You ought to go ahead and buy 20 at least, and have those four just, if those four sit in a box, then great. You know, if you have some failures a year from now, even if you put those in and they're better than the other batteries, it's still going to be a situation where even if they're better than the other ones, the worst thing that you're going to have happen is that those four are performing to the lowest battery in that other cell. But you've kind of protected your investment by making sure that all those batteries are in that, that you've got backup batteries ready to go. So that's some of the things you need to be very, very particular about and aware of when you're putting these lithiums into operation in your home. So the benefits of them, I mean, if you're looking at the dollar side of that, I mean, that's where the really big benefit comes in, is that in any of the other situations that we're working with, these things, you know, probably are costing somewhere around, probably by the time you add some extras in, that sort of thing, you're probably looking at least even a 60% less than if you're buying a battery that has a built-in BMS, that has a big warranty and all those sort of things. So it's a significant savings. The other thing that I like about them, and one of the reasons why we put them in our house, is the ability to pull a cell out. So if we have any kind of repairs that we need to do, and I say repairs, like repairs on that battery, you know, you can pull a cell out and replace it. You can drop another one in there. So I'll move in and move on, and we'll start talking about the BMS that we've got here. So Daly BMS, these are all over. You know, Amazon has them. We've got them. I mean, I just want to tell you, you know, this is a very common piece of equipment that's out there. You know, we want to be real competitive with them and have them available for you when you get your batteries from us. A couple of big things about the Daly is that there's a lot of different models out there. You need to really look at what you're getting with that. One of the things that we would put out to you to begin with is, as we put this and install this, it comes with this little unit, and you think it's all cool that they have a Bluetooth and that you can Bluetooth it in. One of the first things it wants to do is know your location. Now, I am a nut on many different levels. I'm not a big conspiracy nut, but I haven't figured out why Daly needs to know where this unit is in the world. So we kind of chucked this aside. We're not interested in anybody knowing, you know, exactly where our stuff is. Okay, so that kind of gives you a big broad picture of some of the stuff that's happening. Let's get into some of the actual details. We're going to bring the camera in, and I'm going to go over exactly how we've got this all hooked up, and maybe that'll help you understand how you can put this together in your operation. Okay, so the first thing you need to know about working with the lithiums is these things will bite you really hard. And I wish I could say that I was reading that off a script, but I know that because I popped myself with them once, and you don't want to have it happen. You don't want to have sweat on your arm. You don't want to have anything like that going against these whenever you're messing with them. These things will bite you so hard and so fast that you won't even know what hit you. The other thing you need to do when you're looking at these batteries is you need to not assume anything about colors, because China will color them however they want to. We've had them actually where white was negative and black was positive and everything in between. So you need to look specifically and make sure that it is either marked or you check it with your meter to make sure that you've got your polarity right. The other thing that we're looking at here, in this little configuration, we just made a little 12-volt battery. So we've got four 3.2s. The other thing you need to make sure is that your bus bars are all going to be of equal size, right? So in the ones that we made for our house, we actually had to toss the bus bars out because we were making a 48-volt system, and the way the batteries were laid out, it didn't allow for the bus bars to be used to give everything an equal distance on the bars. So for purposes of keeping the batteries all being charged and discharged equally, you've got to have those at the same length. So we actually made our own bus bars basically to be used here. So that's a big thing. So in this case, it just happens that this works out. But know that if you're making a bigger, higher voltage, that you may have to make your own bars here. But so we've got this basically set up in series. And then, again, this is a 12-volt system. So on the BMS, what you've got here are these are the leads that come into the BMS system. All right? And so what happens is your BMS over here is just breaking one leg. And in this case, this is breaking the negative leg. So when the system reads whatever it needs to, it's going to basically break that connection. It's also got a fan that's running here. So what we've done here is we've added some ring terminals on here for ease of use. These wires, all these wires on this, I mean, they are angel hair thin. And trying to get all these to work out right, it was just a lot easier to come in and add these ring terminals on. And particularly if you're doing the higher voltage batteries where each one of these leads, you know, you may have, you know, 8 leads or 16 leads. It's much easier to have those with ring terminals. And then what you're doing here is basically you've got your first lead here is black. That's going to go to your one negative up here where your main leg is coming in. And then each one of these is in turn going for each one of the positives. And the way this works is it works from your first battery, second battery, third battery, fourth battery, fifth battery, and it's got to go in and it's got to be hooked up in that fashion. So if we run this particular wire back, this is battery number one on cable number one. So this is number two. So this comes in here, so that's number two. And this is number three, so that's number three. And then number four. So this is all, or excuse me, number four. So this is all hooked up. So that's how the monitoring takes place. If you do that wrong, if you put those in wrong, there's a chance that just nothing will happen. Your display won't show, or it won't, you know, more than likely the display won't show. But there is a chance that you can just pop the whole system and get the opportunity to buy another one. So you want to make sure, and that's, again, we're coming back to you, want to make sure that you know what your polarity is on each one of those terminals. So you'll take that, you'll connect this in here. So that brings this all together, all right? Now, your display will come, and all the ones that we're selling here at Missouri Wind are gonna come with the display because we just feel like that's necessary. So your display, it comes as a separate unit, and you plug it up here on the top. And some of these will come with this little wake-up button. But what this does is that wakes the display up. Now, the display and what this does is very cool. I mean, I love this. I mean, not being the most super battery technical guy, this makes it incredibly easy for me. Okay, so now that we've got everything connected up, our display is lit. One of the easiest things that's always readily available is your battery percentage. That's right there in the middle, so you can glance at that real quick. Another thing that I always like to just look at, and it's great to have it on the screen very easily to see, and we'll talk about a little more detail, is your max voltage and your minimum voltage. We'll talk about that just a little bit more, but that's always great to have right there where you can see it. And then your alarm list. Hopefully it's always blank. I hope there's never anything on your screen. Sometimes there is on mine, and we'll talk about that a little bit more. So your max and min on your given battery, that tells you what the maximum cell is in your battery. So one of your cells has a maximum voltage. In this case, we've got one cell that's at 3.245. And then we've got a minimum cell. So one of the cells is at a minimum of 3.218. And so we can target that a little bit faster if we go to the next page. And we can see now this numbers the cells out exactly where they are. And so you can say, well, our high voltage here is number 2. It's at 3.2. And our low is number 4. It's at 3.21. Now, this is a little 12-volt system, so there's only 4 batteries and there's not a lot in it. But if you've got a 48-volt system like we've got at our house, you've got 16 of those batteries in there, and being able to spot a problem cell and replace it is always great. And you would have even an alarm here if you had one particular cell that was acting up. And you'll get periodic messages up there that let you know if something's going on wrong. So the BMS is just keeping track of that, and you're able to come in here and take a look at that any time of day and just be able to catch that. I mean, it really, once you've got it, it's kind of a, you know, set it and forget it and just check in on it and make sure everything is working within range. So that kind of wraps it up. I think some of the big points, big takeaways you need to make sure with, first, foremost, last most, middle most, safety on this. These things are incredibly powerful. They'll bite you in a heartbeat, and make sure that you're being safe all the time. Make sure there's no extra metal. I know that sounds crazy, but even as you're tightening those lugs up with your Allen wrench and what have you, just make sure where that is at all times. Make sure you don't have any, you know, sweaty arms. I mean, it's getting to be about summertime. Sam has always helped me with this. Actually, by helping, I mean he's done a lot of it. But the other thing that we both do when we're working on it is pull wedding rings off, anything like that. It's just not worth getting a cooked finger over. So make sure you're being incredibly safe with this. The other thing is just to also make sure about that polarity. I mean, that's a surprisingly big challenge with these Chinese batteries that we've come across, and making sure, hooking something up backwards is going to be very expensive and, again, very dangerous. But once you've got this set up, I mean, it really seems to just move right along. We've had great success out at our house. We'll keep you posted on that. And if you need any other further help with that and help on setting this up and getting this type of thing configured, just reach out to our sales team and we can work with you on that and help you get that put together. But thanks for checking the video out.